Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for coming in and checking out the channel today. And today, we've got a nice quick one for you that you can jump straight into to help set up your Cloudflare Tunnel. Now, if you've seen our full-length Cloudflare Tunnel video, which uses the CLI to help you set up your tunnel and connect it with Cloudflare, that guide is still valid and still works because CLI is still supported and you have two different options to use the tunnels now. So recently on the 25th of March, Cloudflare announced that you can now use the web UI in their Teams dashboard to set up tunnels that way, rather than having to go through the CLI and managing it through the Cloudflare Docker container. There's a whole article here that they've written up, which I'll link down in the description for you to have a read to help you decide whether it's something you want to look at. But all you need to know is if you've already got your tunnels working and existing, you don't need to change anything. And once you go to the UI, you'll see your existing tunnels there as well, which I'll show you in a moment. So this is more for any new tunnels you want to set up if you haven't set up a tunnel before, or if you've been thinking about setting up a tunnel but you just wanted an easier way to do it, today's your day. So we're going to show you real quick how you can do that through the new UI, and that will be part of our Cloudflare series, so it'll go hand in hand with the CLI option if that's something you choose. It is explained really well in here why you'd still want to prefer CLI in certain scenarios, but I think for the most part, most of us home users, the UI works just as good. So, without further ado, let's just get stuck into it and show you how to do that. Okay guys, so first thing you're gonna need to do is log into your Teams dashboard for Cloudflare. Now you can do it by accessing cloudflare.com, then going to Teams. Alternatively, you can just go to dash.teams.cloudflare.com, as you can see up in the address bar. And now, as I said, we already have some tunnels visible. So as you can see, here are our tunnels that already exist, and it'll show you whether they're currently active or inactive. So it helps you also troubleshoot how your tunnels are going, if you like, from your Cloudflare Access dashboard. So these are our existing tunnels. We did all of these through the CLI. We haven't set those up through the UI here. Those were done following our existing guide. But let's say you want to now start by using the UI to set up a tunnel. How would we go about that? So let's go ahead and do that now. Up the top here, we can see create a tunnel. Click on that, give it a name. I'm just gonna call this one IBRAProxy. We'll save the tunnel, and then it will ask us to install the connector. Now, as you can see, we have the option for Windows, Mac, Debian, Red Hat, and Docker. So all of those options work for us. So let's go with Docker. Copy this command, and now in our terminal on the server that we wanna use this on, keep in mind, you can use this for Unraid as well, so we should be able to use this command with Unraid for our Unraid users. But go ahead and paste the command in your terminal. So there's our command, it gives us the Docker run, it gives us this whole giant token, and obviously after this video, I will be removing it and setting up a fresh one. But in your scenario, just make sure you keep that secure. Go ahead and execute that command. We're also gonna add sudo to the front. Okay, so as you can see, I got the password wrong. That happens. We've re-entered that and now it's pulling the container down for us. And what do you know? The container is actually now running. Now, if we come back to the dashboard here, we can see that the connector is now responding. It says that it's connected, our nearest data centers in Melbourne and Sydney, and it has our IP address here as well, our origin IP, which I've obviously taken out for the video. It also tells you what version you're on too. So once you're done, go ahead and click next. And now we can set up a couple of extra things. So let's give it a host name and we'll call this IBRAProxy. And then it allows you to pick the domain. So obviously if you have a list of domains, pick the one that suits you. Optionally, you can also add a forward path as well. You can then select a service that you want to publish out. So let's say HTTPS on 443 and then save that. Alternatively, again, we can go to private networks and put in the CIDR that we want. So e.g. 10 dot blah, blah, blah. So this would assume that we have a DNS entry and that in DNS entry points to our server. And on that DNS entry where our reverse proxy is obviously living, it's saying point it to this application. On this particular server that we're testing, I don't actually have any real containers live and running. And so it's not really gonna matter for me. But for you, I would put it to whatever it is you want to reverse proxy to, for example. Go ahead and save the tunnel. And there you go, that's pretty much done. So now if you have a look at the tunnel, it straight away shows up as IBRAProxy. It's showing as active and it's going to this particular route. That's what we've told it to direct itself to. And we can then configure it or delete it if we wish. Now, obviously something worth noting, if I just bring back the terminal real quick, So this is just running the Docker container as opposed to something like Docker Compose, which will allow us to redeploy the app multiple times and not have to remember the initial command. So that's why I still recommend, if you guys want to do this long-term, still follow our video, our full-length video for setting up through the CLI and having Docker Compose, as opposed to running it through a Docker run command, which can get a little messy. But I love the option that it gives you for all the other operating systems like Windows, for example. So you can set up a tunnel on Windows, which is fantastic and gives a lot of flexibility to everyone involved. So guys, I hope you enjoyed that. It's one of our quick little shots to help get you going with the Cloudflare Tunnel. And if you don't understand the benefits of why use a Cloudflare Tunnel, what it can do for you, and why we need it, then be sure to check out the full length video on Cloudflare Tunnels, which we'll put down in the description below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, it really helps us out, or subscribe to our website and join our Discord, all those fun things. Thank you very much, we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.